Now, you often tell us about ridiculous extra charges that you've encountered.
That's right. In fact, not so long ago, we did a whole series on the dumbest ones.
But this one might take the cake, not only because the amount of money involved is staggering, but the time frame will blow your mind. Here's Jill.
So you're looking for somewhere to rent, and you know there's likely to be some pretty big charges. But what if they're not just big, they're outrageous, like
just over $2,000.
At least that's what it ended up costing Amber and Izzy.
So all of that money and you never actually moved in?
No.
We looked through that house for about 5 minutes.
Yeah.
The saga began in 2018, before little Hudson had made an appearance.
At that time, we were living like in a flatting kind of situation, I guess, and we were pregnant, so we wanted to move into a house.
They like the look of this one, marketed by Click Property Management. And knowing how houses fly off the books, Izzy quickly got himself into the office to sign.
And I got to the end of the thing and I was like, oh, actually, could I take it to my partner? She's at work. If that's all right, and we'll go from there. And she goes, yeah, no, that's cool.
I'm the boss.
It took about 10 minutes to reach Amber at her work and only 5 more for her to get cold feet.
Well, I just looked at it. The bond was extremely high. We just didn't have that at that time because all of our money was going on things for the baby.
That plus a letting fee.
The houses that we had looked for before then didn't have a letting fee, but they did.
So Izzy says he contacted a Click manager straight away.
Izzy here, we just wanted to confirm that we are no longer going ahead with the property.
It would have been like 15 minutes after.
So, good people of Dunedin, what would you expect Click's response to be? What costs, if any?
In my heart, I'd say no cost, but I would expect they might want to charge an admin fee.
So how much do you think?
Not more than 50.
None at all.
Don't think you should be liable for any.
If the partner doesn't want it, it's all over.
Well, this is what Click told Izzy.
So we'll be liable for the rent and the break the lease fee.
I cried.
Amber cried.
Because at that time, like, everything was like a big financial stress. Yeah.
Click sent a letter saying they'd settled just for rent to cover the time the property was untenanted. But still, that's nearly $500.
What for? That is incredibly revolting. That's unfair.
So I'd stomp out and tell them to bugger off. That's what I would do.
Yeah, that's just not showing menaki.
The couple thought they were safe anyway.
We looked into for a contract to be legally binding, there needed to be two signatures. And this was a contract between Izzy and myself. Yeah. It wasn't just Izzy. I hadn't signed it.
But wait for it. Click said one signature was enough.
No, that's crazy. Don't tell me that's the law, is it?
Yes, it is. Scottney, a property management consultant, knows tenancy law inside out.
Tenancy law has its own peculiarities.
Like?
You can have two people on the contract, but only one needs to sign to make it binding.
And so that's different from a lot of contract law?
Yes. Contracts for the sale of land, for example, for signing for mortgages, where there are more than one person on a contract, they do sign and they're required to sign.
And even more peculiar.
In some cases, you don't need to sign at all.
A verbal agreement to rent a house would be binding.
Do you think many people know that?
No. I suspect they probably don't know that. That's the reality.
He's right.
Why don't we know that ahead of time? In other words, these are the rules, now let's go from here, right? Otherwise we'll trap you.
Amber and Izzy sure felt trapped. They firmly believed they shouldn't pay, so they didn't, which is why Click says it had to take them to the tenancy tribunal.
And you were happy with that?
Yeah, I was. I was happy with that.
Because he thought they'd win. They didn't. The tribunal ruled the couple had to pay the $483 in rent. And it gets worse. Click added other costs, the letting fee from the original contract, and a partial break lease fee, making the total over $1,300 for a contract lasting less than an hour. Click sent us a statement saying they sympathise with the tenants, but that people need to be aware of the consequences of breaching a contract. The couple still feel the charges are excessive, and reviews show Click has other dissatisfied customers too.
Worst property management company ever.
Money hungry.
At a joke.
Amber and Izzy were resigned to repaying and say they verbally agreed this with Click, but before payment started...
I was saying that they've taken it to the debt collection agency, so that's where all the other money is added on top of it as well. It's
$2,100
and something.
Which they're now paying.
It's week to week.
Yeah, pretty rough going.
Yeah.
So unlike Hudson's favourite book at bedtime, this story doesn't have a happy ending. It's more of a cautionary tale about the clauses agencies can use if they put money before monarchy.
I don't know, I just don't understand how people can sleep at night knowing that they're just taking money from good people.
You know what? I got a message for Click Property Management. That may be legal, but that is mean. You guys are mean. That is no good. I'm not happy.
I'm gutted for them. Look, the good news is that laws have since changed and now rental companies are no longer allowed to charge letting fees.
Which is superb, but legal or not, Click Property Management, they were taking the old, weren't they?
Taking advantage.
Yeah.